Today we are going to discuss about different food colors. What is food color? It is simply an additive which is used to color different food products. In simple language, it can be defined as any dye, pigment or substance that imparts color when it is added to food or any drink. They come in many forms, consisting of liquids, powders, gels, and pastes. It is used both in commercial food productions as well as in domestic cooking. People associate certain colors with certain flavors, and the color of food can influence the perceived flavor in any food product. Color additives are used in foods for many reasons, including to make food more attractive, appealing, appetizing, as well as informative. Offset color loss due to exposure to light, air, temperature extremes, moisture, as well as storage conditions. It has also an important role to play to correct natural variations in the raw materials to be used for production of the food product, and also enhance natural color of raw materials. Colors provide color to even colorless fun foods and allow consumers to identify products on sight, like candy flavors. So, overall, food colors are added to food or drink in order to change its color to improve its acceptability by the consumer. Color is one of those important ingredients upon which flavor as well as quality of the food can be judged. Whenever you go to the market, specifically in bottled food products, one must see its color. And even a little variation in color of those bottled products will tell about quality of that product. And if it is not good, it wouldn't be acceptable by the customers. Today's consumers are proactively seeking food products which must contain safe ingredients in them, so that there shouldn't be any adverse effect even after regular and prolonged consumption of that food product. When nature has provided us varieties of natural foods with a wide range of colors, then why these additional food colors? Certainly, to improve appearance, taste, and texture of the final food products. It also maintains or improves safety and freshness of the food products. Some of the food colors, being natural ingredients, also maintain or improve nutritional value of the food product. And ultimately, it influences consumer to buy a product through visual perception of the product. Now let us see history of different food colors. Around 1500 BC, candy makers of Egyptian cities have been reported to use natural extracts and wine in order to improve product's appearance. Around 1200 BC, that is in Bronze Age, Cleopatra have been reported to use saffron in butter as first colorant to put a rich yellow color. In 1856, William Henry Perkin discovered the first artificial organic dye, that is mauve, by oxidizing aniline while trying to form quinine, an anti-malaria drug. By 1900, many foods and drugs of United States had started using artificial color with many blatantly poisonous materials like arsenic, lead and mercury in order to hide defective or inferior foods, which was proved to be very harmful from health point of view. In 1906, Congress passed the Food and Drugs Act, and according to this, these poisonous or deleterious colors was prohibited to be used in food industries. In 1962, the first EU directive focusing on the use of colorants in foods was published to use only 36 colors, out of which 20 was prepared from natural ingredients and 16 was prepared artificially, and these 36 colors were considered safe for human consumption. In 2009, Barry Callebaut's IBC brand, which was specialized in color and printing technology in food applications, has launched Power Flowers by tempering cocoa butter and 40% coloring agents. Naturally, this question comes in our mind, why food products need to be colored? Simply because these colors, which has to be added additionally in the raw materials, have so many roles to play in the prepared final food product. These colors impart attractive and natural colors to food, which is first characteristic of any food to be noticed. These colors affect identification of flavor also, which plays a key role in defining its quality. This also helps to overcome the damage to appearance caused by the processing for improved visual indication. Colors also preserve the product identity. It ensures color uniformity of the final food products. It intensifies the colors of certain manufactured foods and protects flavor and light sensitive vitamins during storage for long duration because of its sunscreen effect. It gives color to foods specifically which are basically colorless. For example, sugar confectionery, soft drinks, sausage, ice lollies, and soft drinks, so that they can have particular color. These food colors are available as liquids, liquid gel, powders, gels, as well as pastes in the market. Food colors have been classified broadly into three categories, that is natural colors, nature identical colors, and artificial colors. For natural colors, pigments are made by living organisms, be it plant or birds or animals. For example, anthocyanins, carotenoids, annatto, etc. Nature identical colors are man-made pigments which are also found in nature. For example, beta carotene and canthaxanthin. Whereas artificial colors are purely man-made colors. For example, indigo carmine, allura red, brilliant blue, etc. We will discuss in detail about each of these classes. First comes natural colors. As name is self-explanatory, these natural colors are extracted from animals, vegetables, fruits, minerals, and spices. For example, carotenoids are mostly extracted from annatto, anthocyanins, chlorophyll, as well as turmeric, followed by the red pigments and brown colored caramels. Permitted natural colors include anthocyanins, carotenoids, beta carotene, beta apo8 carotenal, canthaxanthin, annatto, and vitellin. Now let us see about anthocyanins, which have been used from ancient times as Romans also used highly colored berries to augment the colors of wine. Anthocyanins are water-soluble compounds, and it is harvested from red to blue colors of varieties of fruits and vegetables. Along with apples, blackcurrants, brinjal, cherries, grapes, red cabbage, strawberries, red currants, and raspberries. And this anthocyanin provides wide range of colors to be used for preparation of different food products, ranging from orange, red, blue, violet to magenta colors. Next is carotenoids, which is very widely spread in different plants as well as in animals. And it was observed that more than 600 different carotenoids are existing in nature. It was estimated that nature produces some 3.5 tons of carotenoids, 5 tons of carotenoids every second. These carotenoids provide natural yellow, orange, or red colors of many food, as well as being used extensively non-toxic, natural, or nature-identical colorants. Chemically, the carotenoids are aliphatic or alicyclic members of terpene group, which contains 8 isoprene units joined in a tail-to-tail manner at the center of the molecule. Carotene can be divided into hydrocarbon carotenes and their oxygenated derivatives, which is known as xanthophylls, including viola xanthine and neoxanthine, etc. Next comes beta carotene. It was first isolated from carrots, and hence its name was given related to that carrot as beta carotene. Other than carrots, it can also be extracted from different food items naturally existing, like banana, jackfruit, maize, mango, papaya, pumpkin, watermelon, red pepper, spinach, peaches, apricots, oranges, broccoli, etc. It naturally occurs in nature, usually associated with a number of chemically closely related pigments and extracts. And beta carotene imparts yellow to orange color, and it is used in low concentration, that is from 0.13% to 2% for preparation of different food products for its color. Oil-soluble form of beta-carotene has been used for coloring butter and margarine, whereas for water-based products like ice cream, yogurts, etc., water-soluble non-mixin products have been used. Next is beta-apo-8 carotenol. This natural color ingredient was first synthesized in 1962, and it has also been extracted from varieties of naturally existing raw materials like pulp and skin of citrus fruits and various fodder plants, including oranges, spinach, grass, and marigold. And this beta-apo-8 carotenol product, food ingredient, is being used in various food products like cheese, imitation dairy products, pastry, whipped margarine, non-standardized salad dressings, and fresh dressing. Next comes canthaxanthine, which was first synthesized chemically in 1964. It is a diketo carotenoid pigment with an orange-red color. It is extracted from water birds, specifically flamingo species, because their feathers, leg, skin, egg yolk, blood plasma, and liver contains this naturally existing food color ingredient. Other than flamingo, Even pink edible mushroom, canterelle, scarlet ibis, and roseate spoonbill also contains this naturally existing coloring material. And various crustacea and fish, along with algae, hydra, and brine shrimp also provide this canthaxanthine food color. It is used in the range of 5 to 60 ppm levels, and this ingredient imparts exclusively red colors. Most important thing of canthaxanthine is that it blends well with beta carotene to produce orange shades and enhance and standardize the color specifically of tomato products. For example, juice, sauce, soup, and dehydrated powders in which this has been being used. Other food applications of canthaxanthine include Russian and French dressings, fruit drinks, and ice cream. Next is well-known annatto color, which is derived from pericarp of annatto seeds. Annatto is a fast-growing shrub, which produces cluster of pods containing 10 to 50 seeds, covered with thin, pulpy, bright orange resinous coating, which serves as a source of this annatto color. It is being used in the range of 0.5 to 30 ppm, resulting in hue ranging from light yellow to dark orange color. Oil-soluble annatto is being used for fat-based products like butter, margarine, creams, spreads, and desserts coloring, whereas water-soluble annatto is being used to color cheese and cheese products. Next color includes betalain, which is water-soluble color and provides red, violet, orange, and yellow colors. This is also extracted from a wide range of naturally existing materials like different fruits, vegetables, leaves of some plants, and underground part of beetroot. Betalain is basically phenolic compounds in plant foods. And this is being used for coloring a wide range of food products like beverages, jams, jellies, ice cream, yogurt, gelatin desserts, canned fruits, toppings, confections, etc. Betalain is relatively safe, and various health benefits are being provided by this food color. And most important thing is that it has no adverse effect even on environment. This is a developing concept in recent years and used as colorant in even organic foods. Since very low level of this color is being used in preparation of different food products, it imparts very less technical defect to different food products. Now let us see limitations of using natural food color. As natural food colors is prepared from naturally existing plants or birds or animals, naturally its raw material will be scarce and available in very less amount, so it will be obviously costlier as compared to artificial colorings. Some of these natural food colors can also cause allergic reactions in some sensitive persons. For example, cochineal extract and annatto have been observed to create some allergic reactions in some sensitive persons. Some sources have their own typical flavor, which may affect the taste of the finished product. For example, turmeric, it has its typical flavor, which may affect the flavor of finally prepared food product. Actual color may not retain as such when subjected to high temperature. For example, grape juice extract. At times, raw ingredients also remain scarce, specifically marigold extract, leading to naturally higher cost. they are required in large quantities when compared to artificial dyes, for example, cochineal extract. These are basic limitations of using natural food colors over artificial colors. Next, class of food colors include nature identical synthetic colors. These are synthesized in laboratories and a very limited range is available to be used in industries. Next group comes including artificial colors. These are synthetic colorants, which is also known as certified color additives. And these artificial colors are broadly classified into two groups, that is FD&C dyes and FD&C lakes. What is the basic difference in these dyes and lakes? Dyes are water-soluble compounds that produce color in solution, whereas lakes are water-insoluble colorants, and it is prepared by combining these dyes with alumina. Varieties of coal tar dyes along with indigo carmine is available in the market belonging to this synthetic food color. There are limited synthetic food colors which may be used for preparation of different food products. For example, you can see here Poncio 4R, carmoisine, and erythrosine can be used for providing red color, whereas tartragine and sunset yellow FCF can be used for providing yellow color to different food products. Indigo carmine and brilliant blue FCF can be used for providing blue color, and fast green FCF can be used for providing green colors to different food products. Use of lake colors as colorant in foods. Aluminium lake of sunset yellow FCF in powdered dry beverages mix can be used at a maximum level of 0.04% weight by weight. And one important thing with this color is that label of powdered dry beverages mix must clearly give instruction for reconstitution of this powder for making final beverage, as maximum limit of the color content in final beverage should not exceed 8.3 ppm and aluminium content should never exceed 4.4 ppm in the finally prepared beverages. So we have seen that natural colors are best over artificial colors, as artificial food colorings have been observed to cause food allergies, behavioral problems, headaches and migraines, depression and attention deficit hyperactivity disorders in various experiments. Now comes inorganic colors, which is strictly prohibited by Prevention of Food Adulteration Act, and only titanium dioxide of food grade can be basically used for preparation of chewing gum, that too at a maximum limit of 1%, and no other inorganic matter and pigments can be used for preparation of different food products by food industries. So different food colors permitted by Food Safety and Standard Authority of India includes carotenoids, chlorophyll, riboflavin, including lactoflavin, caramel, annatto, saffron, curcumin, and turmeric. These food colors can be used whether they are isolated from natural colors or produced synthetically, they may be used in or upon any article of food as per FSSAI. Thank you. Thank you very much.